to Richard Mabey Presents.
Hello, YouTube friends. This is Richard Mabey with Richard Mabey Presents. It's Monday, July 31st, 2023 at 11:27 in the morning. And there's Bucky on the inside garage door wall. And I'm wearing the St. Augustine baseball cap and the Gators Dockside t-shirt. Here's the funny part. I've never been to Gators Dockside. And I got two of these Gator Dockside shirts at thrift stores for a buck a piece. So that was a good deal. So busy day, busy day today. I'm going to power wash or get as much done as I can, power wash the house today. So it's been a while since I power washed. I'm kind of embarrassed because it got a little out of control. So without further ado, I'm going to start power washing my house. So as Jackie Gleason would say, away we go, YouTube friends. I've got my power washer here, and I haven't used this in a while. This, of course, got my name on it, and this is garage item number 170. It's kind of a special number for me. That was the my Boy Scout troop number in Lincoln Park, 170. So, yeah, I'm going to take this out of the storage in here in the garage and plug her up and put her to use. So that'll be interesting. So here we go. My power washer outside here. And this is the outer border of the golf cart garage door. That's what I'll be doing in a few minutes. I just noticed the bird baths were a little low, so I had to fill them up. Now this, on the light here, I'm not going to power wash this. I'm going to try and clean that with a Brillo pad or something like that. So this is the goal for right now, to get this siding done here. But first I'm going to put water in the bird bath. My old power washer. I like my power washer. So YouTube friends, I came in to fill the big bucket with water, to put water in the bird bath. And I said, now let me take a moment and read some Psalms in the Bible. I have to read Psalm 8 again because I got distracted while reading Psalm 8 about a month ago or so. So I do have to read Psalm 8 again for a YouTube video. So I have a tendency to put pictures in books, you know, photographs, old photographs, you know, put them in books. So I'm going through the Bible, and I sometimes just open the Bible at random and read that page. So, and I came across this old picture when I was a young man with my Shetland sheepdog Gidget. So I'll take a look at that right now. So why not? Right, I was just took a moment. I said, let me read a few verses of the Bible. I opened up at random, and I had this picture here when I was a young man with my, this is at the old Mabey homestead, with my dear sweet Shetland sheepdog Gidget. And great memories. I'll tell you. Back when I had a head full of hair, there were great memories there. You see the Afghan on the couch. Just a great memory. Gidget was just a wonderful dog, very smart dog, very loyal, just a wonderful pupper. Yeah. Time marches on. So okay, I got to get going and clean the bird baths and put fresh water in the bird baths. So, who's your phone call? I'm watching the side of my house.
get the wrong idea.
It's an action-packed video here. Let me get this a little better here. This is a really action-packed video here. Okay. I gotta show you what a great job this does.
Your two friends,
you right
back.
See the parts that I did here coming on, really did a great job here. As I said, the lamp I'm gonna clean up with a Brillo pad, and then you can see where I left off. So I'm gonna continue that on, and no need to film every minute of it, but just to, I wanted to give you a feel for action-packed video of me power washing my house. I'll tell you, this little power washer, it's got some power. YouTube friends, I got this little corner done here. I'm rather proud of myself here. Right in here, this corner here, I got it all done. It takes a little time, a little patience, a little bit of hard work. Right here, I ended up chipping the paint. I said, "Now let me try power washing it," and I chipped the paint. So now I have to paint that lamp there, paint that, get some white paint and paint that. I'm kind of bummed me out doing that, but all in all, I did. Tell you what, this little guy's a powerhouse. I think overall, I did a pretty good job here. I've got a whole lot more of the house to do. But I'm kind of proud of myself getting this done. This was all in pretty bad shape, and I got it cleaned up pretty good. Getting something done today. YouTube friends, I still have the bordering on the main garage to do. I want to get that done today. So I decided to take a little break, sip a little bit of water, take a few sips of water here at my desk in the garage. And I was going through an old tub and I came across my collection of Toastmasters books. And in 1991, I served a 1 year term a 1 year office as vice president of AT&T Toastmasters in Morristown, New Jersey. And then in 1992, president of the AT&T Toastmasters Club for a year. And I bought this set of books. At the time, it cost me over $100. But at the time, you know, I had a little more folding money than I do now in my wallet. So now I there's no way I would buy them now. But at the time, I think they were like $100, $150. But I read all the books cover to cover. Actually, I read quite a few of them. I read two or three times. So I'll show that right now. Friends, here we go. This comes in a beautiful casing. This is like a thick cardboard. This is Jacob N. Broad's Complete Speakers and Toastmasters Library in 8 volumes. And I was about $150 I paid for this. And this, I'll tell you, this is real literature here. Business and professional point makers. Rhyme and verse to help make a point. Speech openers and closers. How to use this library. Remarks of famous people. Origins and firsts. Human interest stories. Definitions and toasts. Proverbs, epigrams, aphorisms, sayings, and bon mots. Yeah, I'm having trouble focusing here. That's odd. There it goes. Yeah, this is a beautiful set of books. As I say, I ordered these. This was actually from Toastmasters International. I bought this set of books around 19, before I was elected as an officer. About 1989, I bought this set of books. It was about $150 or more. As I say, you know, back then I had a little more folding money in my wallet, but of course now there's no way I could spend $150 on a set of books. Okay, I'm going to have to put this set of books here in the in my little bookcase behind my desk here in the garage. As I say, you know, a lot of these books I read, some of these books I read 3 or 4 times. Great literature here. This is real literature here. So, well, back to work.
Hello, YouTube friends, there's a hawk way up there. I don't know if I can get it, if I'm getting it now or not. Oh, what a beautiful hawk. I hope I'm getting it. So, at any rate, this is the exterior post I'm going to do next here. This is really, believe it or not, this only went to pot the last month or so. Otherwise, it had been in pretty good shape. So hopefully the power washer will get this cleaned up here. Again, I'm not going to try to clean the lamp because it just takes, it's so powerful, it takes the paint off the lamp. So, all right, I'm going to get right to work here.
Back to work here. So, got my work cut out for me here.
Okay, YouTube friends, I'll show you what a great job this has done so far. You can see what a great job this power washer does. As I say, the lamp, I'm gonna come back and clean that up with a Brillo pad or just hot soapy water. And there's the part, I still gotta do this, but it gives you an idea. I didn't want to get too boring, but this is what I've got done so far, and I'm gonna do the rest of this little bit here off camera, give you an idea. You know, these I got this from QVC, and one Sunday we came home from church and Cooking with Dave was on, and this was the deal of the day for QVC, and I forget what we paid for it. Wasn't all that much, but saved a lot of money in terms of, and now they're getting like $150 to power wash your house. If you have a corner lock, because you gotta paint the white area. That's kind of like a semi-sidewalk kind of thing. Yeah, so I saved a lot of money buying this. And it does a pretty good job. It's got pretty powerful little power washer there. Okay,
hello, YouTube
back to
friends.
Work.
I just ate lunch, and it's a little after 2 o'clock in the afternoon. And while I was eating lunch, it poured. I mean, it just poured, and it was thundering out and lightning, and it stopped now. But I can hear thunder in the distance. I don't know if the camera's picking it up. So at any rate, I still have a lot to do, power washing, and I'm getting kind of tired. I'm getting kind of winded. So, but I'm going to the cardiologist next month, and you know, get checked out. I get winded easily. I'm going to be 70 in September, beginning of September. So getting old. you can hear the thunder in the background. Hopefully, I'll get some more work done before it starts raining again. It's really cloudy out. It's dark out, so it's very foreboding. But yeah, I had this idea of it's not formulated. You know what I mean? But I would love to get like a minivan. And like sell the house and live in a minivan for about a year, just travel around. I like to go to Nashville, go into Tennessee, where the Dollywood is, and Nashville, and Gettysburg, hit Pennsylvania, and film Gettysburg, and in Maryland, Antietam battlefield, and things like that, and catch the sights and sounds of New Jersey. That Monday morning quarterback I wish I had filmed when I was younger, but I didn't. So yeah, I'm kind of tired. I gotta dig deep and get the energy and get back to work. So without further ado, it's back to work for this guy.
Got so much to do this week, and there's a flower growing here, which I'm really happy to see. It really brightened up my day here, that flower. But I've got I've just weeded this a week and a half ago? And it's all the weeds. I don't use that, the weed killer stuff, because it's supposed to cause cancer. So, but I gotta do all this weeding here. And then over here, I have to, trim up my oak tree here. So I really have my work cut out for me this week. And right here, these branches here, I've got to trim. You can see this is really low here, and this branch here is low, this branch is low, that branch is low. I got a lot of low-lying branches here. So I've got to trim all this up. And then the icing on the cake, my hedges are out of control again. I have to trim them up. I just did that a few weeks ago. I can't remember if I filmed it that time or not. So I've got my work cut out for me here. So I'm going to be busy this week doing yard work. So, well, I don't know if you can hear the thunder in the distance. So I better get, it's really looking bleak out. I better get back to the salt mines and get some work done before it starts pouring again. All right.
Friends,
back to work. It is raining out and it's thundering out, but I haven't seen any lightning yet. So even though it's raining, I'm going to do my best to get this one column here done. And maybe if I can get this one column done here before the heavens open up and it really starts pouring, I'll be happy. So can't waste a whole lot of time here. I got to get back
to
work here.
So YouTube friends, back to work here. Oh, hold on. I got to check out something's wrong with the plug here. Forgot to plug it in again. helps to plug it in. I'm not getting it higher. Hold on, folks. Be right back. I don't know what's wrong. I plugged it in. Let's see. It's not one thing, it's another.
okay, you two friends, I'm gonna do the rest. I'm gonna do the rest off camera and then show the results. So YouTube friends, before I finish up here, I'm gonna finish it up off camera. Once again, I accidentally hit the lamp, the light, the outdoor lantern, and I have to repaint that. But you can see what I've done. It does this power washer does a great job. Now I've got to finish this all, do this rest of this column here, and I'll do that off camera. I didn't want to get too boring, you know, but I tell you what, it does a great job. It's quite a powerhouse, that little power washer. So there it is. I'll tell you, this is a real workhorse there. So I'm gonna do the rest off camera and show the results. It's really exciting. YouTube friends, I finished up this column and I'm kind of proud of myself. Once again, it's raining out, thunder in the distance. It's looking pretty bleak right now. But I, the main thing is I got this column here done. I'm really proud of that. And now today's Monday. So tomorrow, hopefully if everything goes all right, I gotta try and get this gable here and get that done. That really needs to be done there. Let me see if I can zoom in here. I know I can't zoom in on that. But yeah, that really needs to be done there. So if all goes right, I'm gonna work on that gable tomorrow. I'm gonna have to get the ladder and clean that up tomorrow. It's raining out. It's raining out pretty good right now. So, fellow just walked by this moment, looked at me funny like, what's the nutcase filming? It's raining out and the nutcase is filming his house. So, all right, folks,
so
be right back.
So, friends, I got old faithful. Carefully packed away for tomorrow. Tomorrow I'm going to be doing the big gable here in the garage and do some more of the front of the house. I got to do along the front porch there and then in front of my bedroom window. So I got my work cut out for me. So yeah, so it's going to take a little... call it a day here and wrap things up here.
So YouTube friends, that's going to wrap up another action-packed episode of Richard Maybe Presents. As I say, tomorrow I'll do the gable on the on top of the garage, on the garage roof there, that gable there, and then I'll do my the area by the front porch, and then that exterior wall outside my bedroom window. So that's the goal for tomorrow. Right now it's 20 minutes to 3 in the afternoon. I'm gonna go in and make a cup of hot Earl Grey tea and then watch this, they call it Tombstone. They have the Tombstone Epitaph and it's at 3 o'clock on the Grit Cowboy Station. I watch Tombstone at 3 o'clock pretty much every weekday, you know. It's on. I like it a lot. It's a black and white, old black and white show from the 50s, old western. I like it a lot. So I'm gonna go in and then after I watch Tombstone, they show two episodes from 3 o'clock to 4 o'clock. They show two episodes, then I'm gonna do the edit, and then tomorrow I'll put this episode up. So, stay happy, stay healthy, stay positive. This is Richard Mavey, signing off.